Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a React Native Expo app with AI chatbot integration, and we will be making a super naughty AI chatbot. I will be using Gemini 2.0 flash model because it's powerful and super cheap, and as a developer, you must know how to manage your expenses well. You can see the demo of what we are going to build right on your screen, and if you don't want to write the code or spend time on it, you can grab it, the link is in the description. So without any delay, let's get started. So first, we are going to start an Expo project. If you are new to Expo, just follow the video and we will be good to go. Here I want the latest version and I also want to pick a template. I will be selecting a blank template with TypeScript. Alright, I am naming my project Nerd AI. Now wait for a few seconds as the dependencies for the project are being installed. Next, navigate to the newly created directory. Here we will install two npm packages, one for icons and the other for Google Generative AI, which we will use for the chatbot. Install them one by one. I will add the installation command in the description. Now open your project in your favorite code editor. If I show you my package.json file, these are the dependencies and their versions that I am using for this project. Alright, now it's time to write some code. Since app.tsx is our main file, I am going to write the code in this file. However, I have already written the code, so instead of writing it line by line and making the video unnecessarily long, I will just show you my code and explain it. You can pause the video and write the code yourself or use Google links to extract it. It's up to you. So here is my code, now let me explain it from the beginning. First up, the app starts by bringing in a bunch of tools from React and React Native. From React Native, we grab useState to keep track of things that changes, like your messages. UseRef to point at stuff like the chat list, and UseEffect to handle behind the scenes setup when the app loads. From React Native, we pull in essentials like text for displaying words, view for laying out sessions, and touchable opacity for tappable buttons. There is also text input for typing, flat list for showing the chat history, and keyboard avoiding view to make sure the keyboard doesn't mess up with the layout. Add in activity indicator for a little loading spinner, animated for smooth fits, and iron icon for cool icons, and you have got the toolkit. Oh, and we are bringing in Google Generative AI to connect to Google's Brainly AI model. More on that soon. The app hooks up to Google's Generative AI using a line that creates a Gen AI object with a secret API key. It picks a specific AI model called Gemini 2.0 Flash to handle the chatting. Now to get the API key, go to Google and search for Google AI Studio. Click on the official link. If you are opening it for the first time, you will need to accept the terms and conditions. So just accept them. On the left hand side, you will see the API key option. Click on it. On the next screen, click on create an API key and your API key will be generated. Simply copy it and paste it into your project. Also, don't use my API key, I will be deleting it before this video is uploaded to YouTube. To keep the chat organized, we set up a simple plan for what a message looks like. Every message needs three things: a unique tag, the actual word, and a little note saying if it's from you or the AI. This keeps everything neat and tidy. Before we hit the main app, there is a small helper function called action button. Picture those quick start buttons on the welcome screen, like research or code. This little guy takes an icon, a label, and an action to run when tapped. It's a reusable tappable box with an icon and a text inside, styled to look modern and clickable. When you tap it, it starts the chat with a preset message. Simple but super handy. Now we are in the app function, the core of these whole things. So let's break it down. In the app function, we use the useState hook to keep track of three important things. First, there is the list of messages in the chat, which starts empty since there are no messages when the app loads. Then we have the text that you are typing in the input box, initially set as an empty string because you haven't started typing yet. Finally, there is a loading indicator that tells us whether the AI is currently processing a response. It's like a yes-no switch set to false at the start, but it flips to true when the AI is thinking and back to false when it's ready. It also uses useRef to grab onto the flat list, the chat scroll area, so it can automatically scroll to latest message. And it sets up an animated dot value to control the fading of the top bar when the keyboard pops up. When the app starts, it sets up a trick with a use effect. it listened for the keyboard popping up or going away. On iOS or Android, it uses slightly different events, but the idea is the same. When the keyboard shows, the top bar fades out, opacity goes to 0, and when it hides, it fades back in, opacity to 1. This keeps the screen clean while you type. The send message function is what happens when you hit send. It checks if you have typed something, no empty message allowed. If you have, it makes a new message with your text, marks it as yours, is user to true, and adds it to the chat. Then it clears the input box and tells the app that AI is working, is loading to true. It calls generate AI response to get the AI's reply, adds that to the chat, marked as not yours, and stops the loading spinner. The generate AI response function talks to the AI. It takes your message, adds a fun instruction, respond in simple English with a witty and slightly naughty tone, and ask the AI to reply. If it works, you get the AI's text back. If it fails, it says something like, "Oops, my circuit jammed, try again." The AI might use asterisks to make text bold. The render response text function splits the AI's reply into parts. Regular text stays normal and anything between asterisks gets bold. The render message function decides how each chat bubble looks. If it's your message, it's green and on the right. If it's the AI's, it's yellowish and on the left. Your text is plain white, while the AI's might have bold bits thanks to rendered response text. Here I use a style sheet to write the styles of the rendered message, which I will show you soon. The app's look is built in the return part. The foundation of the UI starts with a main container, which is implemented as a view component in React Native. You can see that I am using styles.container here. Now if I show you my style sheet code, you will notice that the container style has a black background and serves as the backdrop for entire application. It's similar to a CSS property. At the top of the screen, the status bar is configured using the status bar component. It is set to a light style, meaning the text and icons in the status bar, such as the time, battery, and the network indicator, appears in light colors. Below the status bar, there is a top bar implemented as an animated.view component. The top bar contains the app title, not chat, displayed as text, accompanied by a chat bubble icon sourced from the IN icon library. Additionally, there is a setting button featuring a settings icon. You can see all the styles used in this top bar section. The top bar has a dark background color and includes a bottom border, visually separating it from the rest of the app and giving it a cool appearance. Moving down, the next major component is a keyboard avoiding view. The component is essential for handling keyboard interactions on mobile devices. It adjusts the layout dynamically when the keyboard is down, ensuring that the input area remains visible. On iOS, the behavior is set to padding, which adds padding to the view to accommodate the keyboard. A vertical offset is also applied to account for the top bar and the other elements, ensuring proper alignment and spacing. Within the keyboard avoiding view, the UI adapts based on the state of the conversation, handling two primary scenarios: when there are no messages and when messages exist. When there are no messages, a welcome screen is displayed. This screen is implemented as a centered view component containing greeting text, "Good morning nerds," and a sub-greeting, "How can I help you today?" Below this text, several action buttons are arranged in row. Each action button has a touchable opacity component styled to resemble a button and includes an icon and a label. This button represents the predefined topics such as research, brainstorm, analyze data, create images, and code. When a user taps on these buttons, it adds a corresponding messages to the chat, simulating user input and initiating a conversation on the selected topic. When messages exist, the conversation is displayed using a flatlist component. Flatlist is chosen for its efficiency in rendering lists in React Native, especially for potentially long conversations. Each item in the list represents a message, and the renderMessage function is responsible for rendering these items. This function creates a view for each message, with a styling that differs based on message origin. User messages are aligned to the right and have a green background, while AI messages are aligned to the left with a yellowish background. If the AI is in the process of generating a response, a loading indicator is displayed at the bottom of the chat list, providing a visual feedback that the app is waiting for the AI's reply. At the bottom of the screen, the input area is implemented as a view component with a dark background. This area contains the text input field and associated buttons. The input bar includes three main elements: an attach button, the text input field, and the send button. The attach button is a touchable opacity component featuring an attach icon. The text input field is where users type their messages. It's configured to allow multiple lines of text and has a maximum height to prevent it from expanding excessively, maintaining a balanced layout. The send button is another touchable opacity component featuring a send icon. This button is disabled with reduced opacity when the input field is empty or when the app is loading the AI's response, providing a visual feedback to the user. When enabled, tapping the send button sends the typed message, adding it to the conversation. Alright, now let me show you the complete styleset code. You can pause the video and write it down. Now it's time to test the app. Open the terminal and run the command npx expo start. You will see a QR code. Scan it using the Expo Go app. Wait for a few seconds and boom, your app is up and running. You can now chat with your AI, and the best part, the Gemini team has done an incredible job with this AI, making the responses super fast and accurate. And yes, you can chat all day, you will get plenty of tokens. So that's it. I hope you successfully built this project. If you did, then hit the like and subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.